Thanks for staying with us. 7:12 Sunday morning. Maybe you know that Red Hot Chili Pepper song, Give It Away. Well, 70% to 80% of American households indeed contribute to charity, but not just important for altruistic reasons, but as well as Fargo financial advisor Faye Shepherd points out, it can help you financially. Welcome, Faye. Thank you for coming in.
Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here as always.
This early? You're kidding.
For you, I absolutely want to show up.
Well, we're thrilled to have you here. What is the primary reason that people give?
People give because they actually feel good. Mm-hmm. And if you listen to all the lottery winners, they talk about paying off that mortgage and helping their family. And then they want to set up a foundation to give away all that money. Makes them feel great. Warm glow.
Yeah, certainly indeed. Now, of course, giving away, as we were just talking about, most people know this, but maybe they don't know enough about it or want to know more about how it can actually help them. Guess what? Tuesday is the tax deadline, right?
Yes,
hint,
it is.
Hint, so timing is not just accidental here. What are some things that people can do?
Well, people can actually make a cash contribution to any charity, a 501c3, that's been designated by the federal government as a charity, and they get a tax write-off, and usually that write-off is equivalent to whatever their ordinary income tax rate is.
Now, how important is a tax bracket to figuring out whether and how much you might want to give away to whatever that charity might be?
It's very important because it really tells you what that benefit is for you financially. It also makes it also comes into play if you give away what we call appreciated stock, and that's really where you get your bang for your buck. So if I take an example of a local company like General Electric that's here in Connecticut, mm-hmm. and let's say you bought $2,000 worth of stock a couple years ago, held it more than a year, appreciated, grew to $10,000. So if you went to sell it, you'd have to pay what we call capital gains tax, or 15% of it on that gain of the $8,000.
Right.
If you're in a 33% tax bracket, a high bracket, about $1,200 worth of tax that you have to actually have to pay on it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you were to donate the stock, it's now worth $10,000. You actually get to write off $10,000 worth. So you only pay two, you write off for 10. You get a benefit of $3,333 by donating the stock, and on top of that, you don't have to pay the $1,200 in capital gains, so you saved yourself in excess of $4,500 off your taxes if you're in a 33% tax bracket.
Just like that. What's the easiest way for people to know what tax bracket they're in, or to find out?
Ask their accountant. There's a marginal tax rate. The more money you make, the more you jump up in another tax bracket. So ask them and really find out where you are. I find that most people really don't know. They're very unsure.
Yeah, I was going to say, too, because, I mean, I don't know, I'm like most people. They're all numbers to me.
They're all numbers.
Right?
And it's
confusing.
We all start out in that 15% tax bracket, but then it begins to creep up. And then depending what your write-offs are, how many charitable contributions that you make, how many donations, how many things you can write off, it could actually decrease the bracket that you're in. So check with your CPA, your tax preparer.
So a good idea, a piece of advice, is to get advice from somebody.
Absolutely.
All right. One other, I think, important question here. Do you have to have a lot to give to charity and to have it make a difference on your taxes? Do you have to be wealthy?
You don't have to be wealthy. You can make that direct contribution, or you can do what we call a donor-advised fund. So you can give a little bit of money to this irrevocable tax-deductible vehicle, this bucket. They're usually managed by community foundations, much as our wonderful New Haven Community Foundation or big financial institution. So you can give a little. Goes into a larger bucket, and then you can actually sit on the committee and make recommendations as where to donate that money.
All right, so the average Joe or Josephine can still benefit.
Yes, they can.
And benefit other people as well.
Absolutely.
Faye Shepherd, Wells Fargo, thank you very much for being
My
in here.
My pleasure.
Wish we had more time, but you know what, if you'd like to get more information, you can go to our website, WTNH.com, and check the Good Morning Connecticut Weekend page and for more information. Let's go over to